intellectual property. This session, we will discuss about Bangkok land crisis 1984 to 2020, as well as house prices in 1994 to 2020. We believe that knowledge is not private property, so we would like to share. But for really detailed information, if you are investors who would like to invest in Thailand, you can buy the report later on. But the knowledge body and the general information, we would like to share to you, so that you can know that Thailand has really rich information produced by our agency for the estate affairs, which is the largest, most comprehensive real estate information center in Thailand. And we believe, as I told you, knowledge is not private property. That's why we would like to share with you. After this session, in the near future, we will analyze the property market around the world for you on the fluctuation of prices. So many people are afraid that COVID-19 would affect a lot to property market. Is it right or wrong? I would like to inform you that I conducted the survey of disasters in the past, like tsunami in 2004 in Phuket, Bandar Aceh of Indonesia, in this whole region of the Indian Ocean affected by this tsunami. 300,000 people passed away within a day. So what happened to the properties there? I conducted a survey in Bandar Aceh of Indonesia already. I also went to Tacloban to see the storm surge, the typhoon that may affect to property market, and to see the property price changes. So we conducted this survey already. I also went to Nepal in Kathmandu to see the earthquake in Kathmandu in 2015. I went there recently so that we can see what are happening in Kathmandu. And we have a conclusion that property price might not be down after that disaster. There are some other disasters as well, like the atomic, after nuclear radiation in Fukushima in Japan, on the before the day of the radiation, I was there in Tokyo, but I came back one day before the earthquake. And just this year, I went there again to conduct the survey. What happened to house price after the radiation? So this is what we are trying to survey. So COVID-19 is another source of disasters. That's why I also trying to find out this. So in a few weeks, I will discuss this with you about the property price after COVID-19. Surely, many people said property price may drop, but it might not be that. I will prove it to you and why it is so. Actually, this presentation will also tell you some part of it, some facet of the facts of that fluctuation of property value. Thailand as a very good case study, because we have rich information. I remember that I studied the property prices 100 years span in London to see the up and down of property prices, the circle, the cycle of property. So that is also very interesting. So I will compile this and make a, this another discussion later. You may know that many years ago, many decades ago, when I conducted my PhD dissertation, I also do this study about property cycle after the property crisis, financial crisis. Okay, so now let me start. Hopefully, our friends are coming. I will try to see any of our friends are here. And if you have any question, kindly raise your hand at any time so that we can discuss, so that it can be somewhat on the, have some, before the day of the participation,
radiation,
have some discussion
in Tokyo.
And this presentation,
I came back,
you consist one day of really rich for the information. And just, you may observe that in many other countries, they may have this sort of information like we have. And we also conducted the survey of this in other countries as well, like in Vietnam, Hanoi, Ho Chi Minh City, Manila, Jakarta, Kathmandu. These are all the cities that we went there to conduct the survey, as well as Phnom Penh in Cambodia. So let us start to discuss about this Bangkok land prices. We have the data since 1984 until today. 94, 2004, 2014. This is 2020. This is 36 years already. One third of a century. And another, in the case of house prices, since 1994 until today. You may know that we conducted the survey of house and other property on monthly basis. Anyone who like the details of this for commercial uses, you can subscribe to our information. But this session is not to sell anything, but just to inform you the overall picture so that you can understand what are happening in Bangkok. And it should be a good lesson to the world as well, because generally in the property markets and the property characteristics are similar in anywhere in the world. Or if we live in the Mars in the future, maybe the characteristics of property might be the same as well. One thing I would like to inform you is that the very nature of housing or other real estate is inertia, inert. The change of property prices are very, very inert. That's why we said the nature of real estate is inertia. It is not as quickly as the stock market. So this is something that we should keep in mind. And this is the reason why real estate is a really good resort for investment to keeping our money. But some may say that in the future, there may be some changes like condominium. In Thailand, owner-occupied walk-up apartments or high-rise apartments on owner-occupied basis, we all call them condominium. Many people said that after COVID-19, condominium market might be down because we need some social distancing. This might be true or might not be true. This is something that we can discuss. There are a few research that we conduct in the past. I mean, recently, that we would like to share you, but maybe in the next session after this. But many facets of the facts would appear here as well. So this is what we discussed. In this picture, you can see this is our grand palace where our king is staying. And also there are some Buddhist temple around the palace as well. And the background at the back is the high-rise complex of buildings. So this is a mixed development in this city. That is the historical city. And on the back is the what we call the commercial or business center of the city. Hey, let me just introduce a bit again. I'm the president of the Agency for Real Estate Affairs and the director of the Thai Real Estate Business School, which is under the control of the Ministry of Education, Royal Thai Government. This is my business. And for social affairs, I'm also the board member of the Employers Confederation of Thailand. Right now, many employees are chased away or maybe terminate the employment. I mean, not my company. I have 120 people in my company. They are all staying with me. But
in my condo unit, still be allowed. When are you done?
Current situation. So,
I'm Susan.
Of the Employees Confederation of Thailand. Formerly, I was the vice president, so we take turn. And also the board member of ethics in the Thai Chamber of Commerce as well. Internationally, I'm also the president of VFC Thailand or VFC Thai and the representative of the International Association of Assessing Officers based in Kansas City in United States of America, USA. And also the chairman of the Islamic Foundation to helping the poor, that is the homeless, as well as the president of the Thai Apprenticeship Foundation. So that is myself. I'm also the member of the Royal Institution of Charter Surveyor as well. These are the properties that we survey or value. Right now, as you see in the past, we also value a lot of aeroplane, airport or something. We went to different places to value properties, or even in Europe, in Japan, and Africa. I was supposed to value a property, a hotel property, in Pakistan, at the border of Afghanistan. Our Japanese valuers do not feel inconvenient to be there. But for me, I think I like to conduct the survey, so I would be there. I went to Uganda or some other places as well. So we have vast experience. We also have friends from Brazil watching, hopefully. So I went to Brazil in a few cities as well, and in European countries. So let me start. The first part is something about housing market. This is the numbers of projects that we survey from 1994 to 2020 for the last 26 years. 1994 to 2020, 26 years. You can see there are so many. This is the Greater Bangkok, we call Bangkok Metropolitan Region, or the metro of Bangkok. The city proper of Bangkok is in the middle and in the vicinity or surrounding provinces, another five provinces. So this is the Bangkok metropolitan region. Our friends from Jakarta, from Indonesia, they also have a similar experience to us. That is, in Jakarta, they have a Jabodetabek. That is Jakarta, Bogor, Depok, Tegalarang. These are all the cities that are around Bangkok, around Jakarta. So they form the metro of Jakarta. So this is the metro of Bangkok. You can see there are so many projects around here. So I will assure to you that we have very rich information for you. The information on our real estate market. Now, I heard that the slide is not working. Don't worry. I will send this slide to you afterwards. If you like, you can put your email so that we can send to you. But one thing I like to tell you is that we, during the last 26 years, we survey around 18,000 projects in Bangkok and vicinity provinces. So we have really rich information for you. So don't worry about this. We will have a lot of information, and we can guarantee you that agency for real estate affairs who prepare this information, they are they conduct the survey, and this is the largest real estate information center. You can see the PowerPoint right now. Okay. Peter, myself can zoom. This is the available warning that ignored. Since we conduct the survey in 1984, we found a lot of information that we already warned people, warned our developers, and warned our financiers, our bankers, as well as our government about what will be happening and about the crisis that you should know about this. So this is what we warned in the past. And we, Agency for Real Estate Affairs, is the only organization that conduct the survey of vacant housing, and I mean unoccupied housing. There were around 350,000 units in 1995. However, most of the developers did not believe me, didn't believe us, did not believe in us. So in 1998, the number of unoccupied housing units increased substantially. And disaster came because of the 1997, 1998, 1999 crisis, financial crisis in Bangkok. There are a lot of speculation in the past. So this is some warning that we put in advance for our investors in Thailand. Right now, we also have some warning. So we will explore this together so that we can know that what are happening today. Let me inform you about the real estate economy. The economy, okay, this is the very latest, information from the IMF, and that is the International Monetary Fund. International Monetary Fund. You can see that the one in yellow is Thailand. Some of your country might be here. That is China, India, Indonesia, Japan, Korea, Malaysia, the Philippines, Russia, United Kingdom, and the United States of America. So these are the countries. There are some other countries as well. Sorry that I did not show you all. Singapore and some others are also here, but sorry I did not show all. But you can see that this year it will be very bad for Thai economy. The GDP, the gross domestic product of Thailand will fall down to minus 7.6%. The situation also not good. You can say that last year, 2019, the GDP growth was only 2.4, only 2.4. And a year before last, it was 4.2. But because of the boosting of the economy, a lot of wasting investment can boost for 4.2%. This is not really good. In Thailand, in ASEAN region, we have 10 countries. Thailand, Myanmar, Laos, Cambodia, Vietnam, Malaysia, Singapore, Brunei, the Philippines, and Thailand. Thailand is the really low, our GDP is the one of the lowest one. Thailand, Singapore, and Brunei, the GDP growth are very small compared to many other countries. Another six countries that are better, like Vietnam, Cambodia, Myanmar. So you can see that this year, in 2020, it would be minus 7.7, which is really low. So everything would be very bad. As a very nature of real estate is that real estate is the dependent variable. It depends on economy. It depends on so many things. So this is the problem of real estate today. So if the economy is bad, real estate market should be really bad as well. So this is the real estate is the dependent variable compared to authors. The authors, like economy, are independent variables. So this is what happened. And next year, the situation might change. Coffee, please. Next year, it would be 5.0. And you can see here that in ASEAN region, most of the countries will be minus as Thailand, but not 7.7%, minus 7.7% like Thailand. Thailand may be the lowest one. In April, it was estimated to be 6.7, but this year, 3 months later in June, the IMF estimated to be minus 7.7, 1% down. So this is worsening in the case of Thailand. But in Myanmar, in Vietnam, the economy is still plus, not minus. Thailand and many other countries are minus, but Myanmar and Vietnam plus because the economy is still grow, but maybe in a not in a very high pace, maybe 2-3% only, but still plus. But in Thailand, it is minus 7.7. So among this region, Thailand is the worst. But Thailand possesses a lot of potential. I'm not trying to sell properties in Thailand. I'm not trying to say that Thailand is good, whereas it is bad. I'm just trying to tell you the truth. And I'm also very independent and neutral because I myself is a valuer and a researcher, not a developer myself, not an agent or a broker myself. As you can see that this year, the situation will be bad, minus 7.7. But next year, it will be 5% plus. So this will be a big jump from -7 up to 5%. This is a very high jump. Unlike other disasters, that the recover, that the recovery may be slow, but this one, the recovery will be very sudden. So this year -7.7, next year will be +5. If the IMF is not wrong, this means that the situation is not really bad. It is not really bad as expected. But this year should be terribly bad. We went to conduct valuation of very big brand hotel in Phuket, in Samui, in Chiang Mai, and many other tourist city of Bangkok. Big name like, as you know, I should not mention the name, but you know, big name like Sheraton, Marriott, Four Seasons, these are all big names. What we can know is that in Chiang Mai, in Pattaya, Samui, or Phuket, the situation right now is not so good, terribly bad. But this situation will last no more than 1 year. Afterwards, the situation will change. There should be some big recovery. This is similar to what we call the great inundation, or flooding in 2011. In 2011, there was a really big flood in Bangkok and the central plain area of Thailand. For 3 months, in many places, people cannot travel there, cannot stay there because the water level may be around 2 meters high. Oh, terrible. But within 1 year, the situation recovered. In 2012, the GDP growth was 7.1%, 7.2%, sorry, 7.2%. So it is quite high. So this situation today will be similar to 2011 recovery in 2012 after the great inundation or flooding. So COVID-19 won't have big effect, but in the immediate situation, it will affect a lot. You can see that the situation is quite bad. You can see that the GDP growth will be -7.7%. So this is the problem today. But don't worry, we will come back very soon. So, but this year, you can see that the affordability of the people will be down. I conduct a study for the United Nations Habitat, or UNCHS, UNCHS in the past, United Nations Center for Human Settlement, or United Nations Habitat. What we can see is that I write a book for them called Housing Finance Mechanism. And we can see that this year, the affordability of the people will be down. So the sale of property, particularly housing, may not be really active. But the demand is still holding. So after the recovery, people will buy. And a lot of people will buy, not just a few of them. So the demand will come back strongly. So this is what will happen. But the very nature of real estate is that dealing is down. We will have panic. Like we go into the cave, we cannot see the light from the cave because we don't know where is the way out, but really dark. But in the near future, the situation would recover quickly as well. one thing we would like to understand is the COVID-19, but this one will not be discussed very thoroughly today. But just briefly, many people are afraid of the COVID-19. I came back from Malaysia on March 1st. At that time, still no really few COVID-19 in Malaysia. And afterwards, they have a lot because of the foreigners coming into the country. In Thailand, also the same. But actually, according to the statistics, only 2% pass away. This is compared to MERS. It is a lot less deadly. So this is something that we should understand. If we get in touch, only 2% addicted with COVID-19. And this 2%, another 2% pass away because of the seriousness. So mostly would be no problem. Don't worry. This is not in the movie, Hollywood movie. But we will discuss this in extensively in the next session in a few weeks. This is the newly launched projects in last year. We have around 480 projects last year. So many also. You can see that the area where there are a lot of projects, I mean, there are a lot of demand in that area. Like in the CBD, in the hub of the city, you can see the conglomeration of the projects there. But in the outskirts, there may be not many. In many of, in a few of them, outskirts, there may be not much not many developments here. Even if they are not far away from the city, but there are not many projects. So this means that there may be no new road proposals, there may be no mass transit. That is why there is no demand. That is why there is no supply. There is no supply means there is no demand, right, in this area. Not not far away to the city, but no roads. I mean, new roads or no toll roads. That's why they are in this area. Actually, this is an agricultural area. So this happening in the past last year. But for this year, for the first 4 months, January to April, what we can see is that this is 89 projects. 89 projects, say 90 projects. If for the whole year, there may be 360 projects. But last year, there are 480 projects. So this means that this year, the number of units, the number of projects and units, and also the value of the development will be down a lot. So this is the problem for this year, 2020. This is the information for the first 4 months. I will tell you the situation in the first 5 months soon. Actually, we just complete the survey of the June launching, the newly launched in June, but we still not yet compile all the information. So we just inform to you only for the first 4 to 5 months. The data from the first 4 months indicate that this year, 2020, the number of units would be really low. You see, there will be 30% minus and 28% minus in the case of the units, 30.6% in terms of value. You can see this year is a big drop. Actually, when we get the information for the first 5 months, the number of drop would be higher than this. But this is just the information for the first 4 months only. You can see that in the year 1994, 1995, 1996, this is in the boom period. But in 1997, 98, 99, this is disasters, a lot of problems because of the financial crisis in 1997. You can mention that you can observe that the crisis in Thailand in 1997, but in the USA may not have crisis there. The crisis in the US, the it was in 1988. At least in 1988, but in 1988 it was a really big boom in Bangkok. But in the USA it was a big loss. And 1997 we have a big crisis, but there is no problem in USA. And 2008 there was a financial crisis in the US, but in Bangkok there is no crisis. So we might be in opposition. I mean, opposite to USA, and in the location in the globe, we are also in different direction, 180 degree different. You can see that since the year 2000, the situation recover and recover until 2004, and then somewhat drop and stable, and then in 2010, it is growing again and growing over time until 2018, 2019, 2020, it is a drop in the number of development and also the value of the development as well as the number of the units launched. These are the number of the housing units launched in the BMR. BMR is the Bangkok Metropolitan Region. Bangkok Metropolitan Region. This is the BMR. You can see from the graph that it is up and down, but now it is in the downturn. So this is the problem today. But next year, we hope that the situation might be better. The demand that curb today would be coming back aggressively next year. So it should be the boom of housing markets and also real estate next year after the economy is recovered. So this is a very important. This is the housing development for the first 5 months, January, February, March, April, and May. You can see that every month, there might be around, on the average, 24 projects. However, you can see that in April alone, the number of projects are really low. Only 12, you can see, only 12. Because in April, there are so many holidays. And in April, it is the most serious month for COVID-19. There are not many people go out of the home. Most of us are staying home. In my office of 120 people, many of them also work from home. Some of them work in our office here, but many of us also work from home. So this is what happened in April. So there are only 12 projects, but in May, the situation recover. You can see that in May, there are 32 projects. Whoa, quite many. Normally, last year, they, in the year 2019, every month, there may be around 30, 35, or 40 projects on the average every month. So in May, there are 32 projects. So this is somewhat recovery. But unfortunately, there are small projects. The size are smaller. You can see that 32 projects here, but yeah, 32 projects, right? There are only 4,471 units. So this means that one project only 100 something units only. They make the project size smaller, make it smaller. You can see that here 4,471 divided by 32. One project will be 140 units. On the average, it would be around 250 housing units or condominium units per project. 250, but now it is only 140. We make the size of the housing project smaller. This is in order to tackle with risk. If they are problematic, if they are in trouble, they may just cancel the projects because the units are smaller, 140 only. But if the large projects, particularly condominium projects, one project maybe 500, 800 units, in that case, if they are in big trouble, they will have to cancel the project. It would be a really big disaster for them, I mean the developer. And we can average the first 5 months, there may be 24 projects per month. However, this is the survey of each month. Every month, we go out to survey new projects, but there might be some projects that we did not see, we may overlook. So you may know that every quarter, we send our team to do the survey again, and we may find some more, another 10% more. So we expect that it might be 27 units more. I mean, become 27 instead of 24. It would become 27 because we may find some other projects. So if 1 month is 27 projects, and if the 7 months, the next 7 months, the situation would be better, say 20% better than the first 5 months. If the next 7 months, the situation might be better than the first 5 months for 20%. This is our wild guess. So we may expect that this year there might be around 357 projects. And when we compare with last year, 480 projects, this is minus 76%, 76% in terms of project, number of projects. In terms of value of units of development, it would be minus 39. And in terms of in terms of the value of the development, it would be minus 36. So it is more minus compared to the information for the first 4 months. So this is what are happening. The number of units launched in year 2020 might be lower than what we expect from the base of 4 months. This is the 5 months. So this is the problem. However, amazingly, the property price would be up. You see, this year, in 2020, the average house price in Bangkok, is $135,000. Our house price in Bangkok is $135,000. The average house price in the US might be around $300,000. So in Bangkok it might be say 40% of the price in the US. Say if it is, if in Bangkok it's 135,000, in the US is 290,000. So house price in Bangkok is only 47% of the house price, average house price in the US. Say roughly 40% in the US. So this is happening in Bangkok. However, the GDP per capita in the US is around 4 times larger than Thailand. But the house price in Thailand is only the 40% of the USA price. So this means that the level of affordability of the people in Bangkok might be lower than in the US. So this is some sort of comparison. But this year price will be, would be higher than last year price. You can see last year price, it was 129. You see here, 129, you see, 129,000. So this is the price last year. The price this year, 135. So it is some 4% increase. Why? Our economy is bad, but house price increase amazingly. Why? Because right now, there are not many developers providing housing for the low-income groups, because the low-income groups, they have no affordability at this moment. So they won't buy a house. But for the well-to-do persons, the well-to-do family, the bourgeoisie, the higher upper income people, they still have affordability. They still possess affordability. So the price that offered this year is somewhat higher than last year, because now we're providing housing for the upper income group instead of the lower income group. So this is the situation in Bangkok. Number of units down. The value of the development down, but the price up, because we do not provide housing for the low income group. We provide housing for the well-to-do person, the bourgeoisie or something. The low-cost housing in Thailand, one unit is around, say, no more than $35,000. So in this case, the low-income people, they cannot buy a house because right now they have no affordability. The liquidity, the money, they may not have a lot of money. So they use the money for other, spend the money for other purposes instead of housing. So this is what happened. Let me speak. Yeah, this is really detailed information for you. However, you need not to know really details. But for the first quarter that we survey everything, now we just complete the second quarter's survey, but we still not yet process on July 23rd, we will have a really big seminar to release this information. We have our research paper of around 1,000 pages released for our subscribers, or you may bought some. So those are information that are really beneficial for the developers, for the financier, for the consultant. That's why they subscribe our information. But as of the first quarter, what we can see is that right now, the number of units available today is around 225,000 units. Bangkok has around almost 5 million housing units, they have 4.8 million. This is 225,000 units available. I mean, on the hand of the developers, not already so already, but still in the hand of the developers. So they are quite a lot. And the largest proportion are those condominium, 42.3%. Yeah, 42.3%. So this is 96,000 units or 42%. So this is condominium. And the second priority are those townhouse. Townhouse in Thailand mean barrack types or row houses for residential purposes, row houses. And we also have row houses for what we call commercial uses, first floor for commercial uses, and the second floor, third floor, and the fourth floor for resident uses. Thank you. So this is what happened. The third in the category is detached house. We have 17% detached house, 17.17. We have 31.31% of those townhouse. So 47% condominiums or only occupied apartment, 31% townhouse, and 16% detached house, and the rest semi-detached shop houses and land subdivision for residential purposes, but there are very few today. So this is what happened. So we still have 225,000 units. in the hand of the developer are available for sale. This number of units, if today we close down, turn off the tap, no more new housing projects, is 225,000 units. You need around 20 months to get off, to sell, to get rid of them, to totally sell them. In 20 months to zero, 20 months, if there is no new supply. But every day there are more new supply. So the number of launching, the number of remaining units are growing over time. But definitely during this month or during this year, 2020, the supply will be less compared to last year. Definitely, the demand also less, but this means that the number of units, 225,000 units, may be down to some extent because the units would be absorbed by the buyers. So the situation should recover next year. This is the really detailed. So we identified that for the first 4 months for the launching, you can see that this one, you can see that condominiums for the remaining units, condominiums are the largest proportion, 42% or 43%. But for the newly launched units, newly launched units. For the first 4 months, around 20,000 units. Only 34% are condominiums. 1/4, 34% only. Amazing. But the largest proportion become townhouse. I mean, row houses for residential purposes. In Thailand, we call row townhouse. This is around 46.5% or 47%. 47%. And detached house become 11%. 11%. And we also have semi-detached or duplex. Two houses attached together, another 8%. We also have a really small number of shop houses. So this is the new composition. Previously, every year, condominium would be around half of the supply. In Pattaya, maybe 70% of the supply. But this year, it is only condominiums or owner-occupied apartments constitute only 1/3. Now they go to low-rise residents like townhouses, detached houses. But in Pattaya, they cannot go high, they cannot go horizontally because they are shortage of land. So they have to go vertically. So 70%, 70 of the supplies, housing supplies in Pattaya are condominiums. But somewhere like in Hanoi or in Ho Chi Minh City, 90 to 95% condominiums. There might be some low-rise residents, but very, very few. Something like in China, nowadays there should be almost no low-rise residents because the scarcity of land. But in Thailand, we go horizontally. This is something that the urbanization process is not so good. And you can see that the price range. Normally in Thailand, the price range around 2 to 3 million baht. The range of around 2 million to 3 million, 2 million baht is, say, 2 million baht is around 65,000 US dollar. To around, 80,000 US dollar. This is the price that really popular, I mean, produced abroad in the first 4 months. But there are also many units that have high price abroad as well. Actually, there are quite a few of them priced up to around over 20 million baht. 20 million baht is around 645,000 US dollar. Actually, there are quite a few housing units like apartments or condominium or detached house priced at around 1 million US dollar or more. One penthouse in Bangkok, in a condominium, worth around 20 million US dollar. Oh my God, 20 million US dollar for a penthouse in condominium projects. And you may know that in Bangkok, the most expensive apartments or condominiums per square meter is around 21,000 US dollar. 21,000 US dollar per square meter. Oh my God, that is a lot of money. Or it is around 1,900 US dollar per square feet. 1948 US dollar per square feet. Why expensive? 1948 US dollar per 1 square feet. But that is just one exceptional project. Mostly are not that high. Normally around 10,000 US dollar per square meter is considered very high or the top end already. But this one is a lot higher. This is an exception, not a norm. But the norm one, say 1 square meter will be around 10,000 US dollar. That is a super luxury apartments or condominium. If you like to see the details, I can show you that the zone that are with the number of largest number of units launched. You see where are they? We divide Bangkok metropolitan region into 78 zones. Ooh, a lot. 78 zones. So these are the zones that have the largest number of units launched. So wherever there are a lot of launching, this means that this is the area of demand, right? And also some area that the highest value of the development. So this means that also high demand, particularly in the hub of the city. The number of units might not be a lot, but one unit is really expensive. So you can see that in the hub of the city here, this area here, there are a lot of new development, high value. But this is the thing that you may not go into details because you are not in Bangkok. But I just try to show you that which are those areas. Like these are the group, like location L3, Bangplat, condominiums, 1 to 2 million baht. They launch around 882 units. Already sold for 101 units. And the rate of sale is 4.4% per month. So this is the information that we will provide for you. Normally, for the those who subscribe to our information, they will know details in every location. Out of those 78 locations. So if you are bankers, you want to see this area is good to give loan or not, you can study our report. Or if you are a developer, you want to know that this area is good to do condominium at the price of around $100,000 or not, you can consult with our data. So this is the very detailed information just to show you that we have really rich information. We are the only source of information that have really rich information like this. Our author, real estate information in Thailand, cannot give you this information. And we release the information very quickly. Say, the launching of the units in June would be released on the 10th of July. So you see, really quickly. And we also conduct the survey every quarter as well. One thing I would like to inform you that the Agency for Real Estate Affairs, which is the information center, we are very neutral and impartial. There is no developer sitting on our head like a board members. No, we are really independent. So this is really reliable for everyone. So these are the units that high sold. You can see where are happening. What which group are really good? You can see that condominium and townhouses are very good for sale. This is the low sold rate. This is really bad. So if you want to launch something similar to this in that particular location, you have to keep up. If you still launch, you would be in big trouble because these units cannot be sold. They will be your competitor. So this is something that you should study in details. This is Coke Zero. Let me inform to you about the public company and the non-public company. This is the public company. And this is the sub-public company. Sub-public company means the company that affiliate to the public company. And the last column is the non-public company. Non-public company are those, what we call private company. Private company here. We yellow it already. You can see that public company and their affiliates constitute around 2/3 of the markets. Whereas the private company have a share of only 1/3. Wow. In Thailand, we have 45 public companies. We have around 200 private companies. And the first 10 largest companies, which are listed companies or public companies, share around half of the supply. So this means that the small developers cannot compete very well. And most of the projects are under the hand of the big companies, but not one or two companies like Coke and Pepsi or something. But maybe 10 or 15 very active public companies share a lot in the market. So this is what happened in Thailand. This also happened in Tokyo. My friend in Tokyo also said that four big companies own around 40% of the condominium shares in Tokyo. But the low-rise residents, there is no one. There are no major players. But for the high-rise apartments, there are only four major ones. There are also some other smaller ones, but four major ones are very important. So this proportion growing, say 30 years ago, 3-0, 30 years ago, public companies and the affiliates share only 1/3, but now they share 2/3. So they are growing. The market become somewhat monopolized, but not by one or two companies, but around 10 or 15 companies. They are still competing each other, but smaller one cannot survive, or smaller one need to compete a lot compared to the big one. Actually, the government should promote the smaller one, like the SME, small and medium enterprises. But in nature, the big one are more advantage, more privilege. That's why they are growing, whereas the smaller one are shrinking. These are the list of the 10 largest companies, but you cannot read it, don't worry. So this is the condominiums along the mass transit. There are condominiums around Bangkok, but this is just only the one that along the mass transit that completed 6 to 36 months. We would like to know the condominiums that completed already 6 to 36 months. Are there for speculation? Any people really move in or not? This is very important information. If most of them still unoccupied, there will be big trouble. I remember that I conducted the survey in 1997. We found that 1/3 of the condominium units belong to the owners. Another 1/3 occupied by the renters. And another 1/3 still unoccupied or vacant. This is a very big problem, because the 100% of the condominium built, the real demand is only 1/3. The real demand mean those who actually buy the unit is only 1/3. That was in 1998, 1999, 1997. But what about now? Let's have a look. We conduct the survey along the apartments or condominium along the mass transit. You can see these are the zone. We found that the unit completed within 6 to 12 months. Why 6 months to 12 months? Why not 1 month, 2 months, 3 months completed? We believe that the units completed within 1 month, 2 months, 3 months, 4 months, 5 months, the buyers may be just prepared to move in. They may do some decoration, minor decoration, because most of the units, condominium units in Bangkok right now, they are turnkey units. I mean, they already built in everything. You just turnkey and put in some furniture only. You can get moving already. No need to do some fixture or do some decoration yourself. And they are moving in the first 5 months, maybe in the moving period. So we won't bother them. We just see those move in within 6 months to 12 months. We found that around 53, half of them, over half of them, over half of the units already occupied. And mostly occupied by the buyers, not the renters. So the situation is not as bad as it was in 1997. So this is something that we should keep in mind, that the situation is not as bad as in 1997. And hence, it would recover soon, maybe next year. So the big slump that we expect might not happen, might not be happen. Let's have a look in the next session in the next 3 weeks. Before I go on, you can see that we also have those who complete the condominium, complete the construction 13 months to 24 months and 25 months to 36 months. Those completed over 36 months or 3 years, we won't survey because there might be, there should be so many people moved in already, completed for 3 months. Except some units, maybe they commit suicide. Commit suicide, maybe it becomes a scar. People may not like to move in. That can happen. But mostly, the housing, those housing units or condominium units should be moved in a lot already after 3 years. So you can see that after we complete, before 1 year, 1 year to 2 years, or 2 years to 3 years, the proportion of those who move in increasing, say from 53% for 1 year to 65% for 1 to 2 years, and 69% move in for 2 to 3 years. So this means that the situation is quite okay. So this is what happened in Bangkok condominium. So the situation is not as worse as it was in the past. And you can see that the price change, I can tell you that right now, the newly offered housing unit, the price decreased. But for those who complete long before 1 year, 2 years, there may be some increase, but really slight increase, maybe 1% increase. Whereas the return on investment, or the yield is around 4%. The 4% is here. Yeah, this is the 4%. See, this is the return on investment or the yield. The yield, we use the monthly rent multiplied by 10 divided by market price. So this is the yield, not the monthly rent multiplied by 12, we just multiply by 10 because we also have to make it the net return. That's why this is understand as the yield. But the return of investment or the capital gain is really thin, that is 1% only. So this is the trouble. If we buy a housing unit, a condominium, we will have 1% from the return of investment, the capital gain, and another 4% from the return on investment or the yield, put together 5%. However, the interest rate, the loan interest rate is around 6%. And the deposit interest rate in Thailand is around 1.5%, really low. So if we borrow money to buy a housing unit, it may not be wise enough today. But in the past, maybe it's good. And also meters for mass transit, the table below, you can see that the more, the farther that you are from the away from the mass transit station, the price will drop. We have an information to inform you that we build a model, a statistical model, and we assume that every meters, the price will drop 50 baht per square meters, 50 baht per square meter. But the, it is not a really linear relation. Actually, it is a curve. If you far away from the station, 10 meters, 12 meters, 100 meters, not much different. But if 200, 300, or 400, big difference. So it is not a straight line. So this is what we should understand. So when we build a model for estimating the premium price per square meter in relationship to the distance to the mass transit, we roughly say that it is around 50 baht per after 1 meter, for 1 meter, every 1 meter that we away from the train station. And you can see that the rent also lower if it is far away from the train station, because mass transit is very important for selecting a condominium unit. If we buy a condominium unit without any mass transit, the price will be lower. And condominium units in the city are of good sales because they have a lot of mass transit. And this is really essential for urban life. But many people may say that in the future, in the near future, after COVID-19, condominium may not be a choice. People may like to stay low rise and have a lot of windows or something so that they can avoid addicting the COVID-19. Is that right? We have to discuss this later in the next few weeks, in the next session. However, one clue I would like to tell you is that condominiums are high density, but not overcrowded. Overcrowdedness can be seen in ghetto, or can be seen in squatter settlements, can be seen in slums, or shantytown. They have overcrowdedness. But condominium, they have high density, but not overcrowdedness. They have privacy. And this may be something that there should be no problem with COVID-19. However, don't worry. We will discuss this in the next session. It should be very interesting to see whether the property price will be dropped. But definitely, if property mean a plane, it might be were very troublesome at this moment. But Delta has sales at this moment. You see, there are many. A moment ago, I talked about condominium projects that complete for 6 months to 36 months, mostly already sold out to the general public already. But this one is the condominium unit already still for sale in the market. There are so many as well. And you can see that actually the price today is down now. You can see the price in quarter four 2019, that is the end of last year, say 3.6. But right now it is 3.4. Oh my God. So it is around 5% decrease in price. I believe that at the end of the year, there should be more than 5%. Because this year is the year of problem. And afterwards, we believe that in 2021, the situation might be better because our GDP is plus 5% instead of minus 7.7% this year. This is the price per unit that you can see that it is decreasing in every price range, say more than 20 million or something. Okay, now we discuss about the land price. You can see here that land price is increasing. Oh, I just realized that. Now it is 10:25 in Bangkok. I have been speaking for almost 1.5 hours already. You might be tired now. So let me just go quickly for the land, which is, this is really important to know as well. Here you can see that land price in the year 1984, if it is one, land price go to the peak in the year 1996, and then down in 1997, 98, 99. And the year 2000, it is going up again. So this is the problem. The year 1994 to the year 1996, that is the booming period. Even if we have the Gulf War in 1991, there is no problem for us. And this is the transformation from agricultural base to industrial base. So this is happening in Bangkok. Land price increased for 33 times. You see, during 1985 to 1996, this is around 33 times, and then it dropped to 26 times, and then going up again. Now it is 66 times, going up really quickly. And the red one, you can see that the red is the annual change. It was minus in the financial crisis in 1997 for 12.6% and also 10.8% in 1998. So this is the big trouble period. In 1999, it is zero, no change. And 2000, it is recovered. So this is the financial crisis. Many expect that property price or land price will be dropped like this. this year because of COVID-19. Unfortunately, sorry to say that it won't be the same as 1997. It won't drop like that. This is not optimistic. I just try to be really realistic. I don't want to be pessimistic or optimistic, but try to be realistic and reasonable. So we believe that this year it will be no drop in land value, but it may be, but it is dropping in condominium value, in housing value. It will drop. Low-rise residents may drop less than apartments or condominiums, but land price won't drop. Why house price drop and land price won't drop? There is a reason. Because house price were priced unrealistically high, higher than realistic. Like apartments in Bangkok, market price is around 140,000, 150,000 baht per square meters. Now it might be 130,000 baht per square meters. It is around, say, 14% drop this year. But land price in that area is still going up because normally in the past, the price and the condominium this is the opportunity, not the problem. The president of the USA also said that they will build infrastructure to boost the economy. This is also the same. They will boost the economy by the land price, by the mass transit in Bangkok. So this is happening in Bangkok. But I may not to go very detailed. I have a lot of information to show you here. Sorry, it is already 1.5 hours. So you can see this one, the last one is that this is the area, the most expensive area in Bangkok in the year. We expect to be at the end of year 2020. Say the most expensive one in Siam Square is around 3.3 million baht per square wa. But you are not familiar with square wa. So it is 825,000 baht per square meters. Yeah, 825,000 baht per square meters. If you are not familiar with Thai baht, it will be, say, 26,000 US dollar. 26,000 US dollar per square meters. See? 26,000 US dollar per square meter, or 2,472 US dollar per square feet. So this is the problem. Sorry, this is the fact about property market in Bangkok, land price in Bangkok. So this is the most expensive land price, the 10 most expensive land price. So I think I should end this. And for land price changes and the property cycle, and particularly the property prices after COVID-19, I will make another presentation soon so that we will discuss this so that people won't be too much panic about this. I can guarantee to you that this will be a really interesting analysis. My PhD dissertation also dealing with this, say 30 years ago. But I still update and also have evidences from many other sources of crisis or disasters created. And COVID-19 is also another disaster that we should overcome soon. Nowadays, there may be big trouble in India, Pakistan, Bangladesh, Brazil, and Peru or somewhere. But in European countries and the US, they should be recovered. So it should recover pretty soon, hopefully. So let me just try to end this session. It is already 1.5 hours. And so sorry that I discussed too extensively about housing, and I hope this should be good for your investment if you like to invest in Thailand. I'm not trying to sell my properties in Thailand or sell Thailand or try to be prejudiced or try to be exaggeration. But I believe that in this region, definitely Vietnam properties and Indonesian property might be very active and really good for investment. But Thailand properties, Thailand condominiums are really stable and really attractive in the sense that we are really liberal here, and the situation is quite peaceful here. There may be some coup d'etat, but this is not a big deal today. So let me just try to do another presentation on the property cycle after COVID-19 in the next week or two, so that we can discuss this in details, particularly for the land prices increases because of the mass transit. You can see that we have a lot of mass transits here. That is why property price going up really, really quickly. Contrary to the fact that the economy is bad, but because of this hope of new mass transit, the property price going up, land price going up, whereas condominium price going down. Yeah, this is something really interesting. So let me just end this. If you need details information, you can contact me. We have report for sale. But if you just want this rough information, you are welcome, because we believe that knowledge is not private property, and we belong to PFC International, that is the International Federation of Real Estate. You may kindly become a member in the future, or you may be already members. We can be a good family here. So let me thanks all of us for watching this session. I hope it would be beneficial for you. And now it is around 10:35 in Bangkok. In one and a half hour, it would be midnight, but it may be still really early in Los Angeles or in New York or other places. So good day or good night to you. All the best to you. Thank you very much. Bye-bye.